Hi there, I'm Shannon, and I blog about simple solutions for six-figure debt over at thefreckledfootdoc.com. I'm going to show you how to make a budget binder to organize your finances in just four simple steps, so stay tuned. Give it a cute home. The most important part of the book is going to get better and better at budgeting every month beyond what works for you and your family. So step one is really simple because I already did it for you. The thing you're going to need are some budget printables to fill your budget binder, and it'll help you organize your finances. So do you really need these super cute, fun printables to organize your budget binder? Probably not. You can just use paper and pencil, or there's a lot of cool budgeting apps out there. But it just makes something that can kind of be kind of annoying to do every month a little bit more fun. I will leave a link below where if you don't already have these, you can grab totally free budget printables to fill your binder with. So that's step one. So grab the link below to get the complete budget toolkit that I made just for you. So step two is to find somewhere to put all of your budget printables so it's nice and organized and they're not everywhere and you're not trying to find them every month. So I really like these disc kind of notebook binders. You can use a regular three-ring binder, but I like these because you can fold it back like a notebook, but you can also still rearrange everything and take it out and add new sheets as you wish. So I really like these, and I can also link below these kind of disc notebook binders and also the hole puncher that goes with them because it's a specific kind of hole punch. That's step two. Give it a cute home. Step three is going to be to make your budget and actually use them. So let me just tell you how I use the different sheets that I've made here in the binder. Monthly payments due. I love this, especially in my business where my income is kind of inconsistent. That way I can know whenever there's like a huge payment that's due or coming up, I can start to plan for it right away. I know in my medical practice, payroll for my employees is coming up the 15th and the 30th, and I'll write it down, and I know those are big expenses for the office. Also rent, that's always a big one, and that's a big expense that's coming up, and I love to see it on the calendar, like, okay, we need to be a little bit more frugal with our money at the beginning of the month because we know rent's coming. Kind of organize and pay our bills depending on when things are due. A bill checklist is something really great to have. That way you can just go through and you know, okay, I've paid that bill for this month. I like to have it a whole year format at a time so I can look and see, oh my gosh, I forgot to pay this bill or this bill's coming up. Organization, seriously, like one of the most important things with budgeting and organizing your finances and being able to pay off debt. So all of these printables, I highly recommend just being extremely organized and really intentional with your money. So a bill checklist is a great thing. Check it off as you go and you get that kind of excited, like, okay, good, that's behind us for the month and that's done, it's paid. A spending log, this is something that might feel kind of old school, like a check register, but I really like to use it since I use cash most of the time for like my personal and my fun money expenses. Spending log helps me to not have to count the cash every day. I know exactly how much is in the envelope, what I spent it on, if I make a deposit in the envelope. And I also love to use this for my business because I still write a lot of checks. And so the bank account electronically is not always completely up to date, which can be really confusing and really annoying for budgeting if you don't know exactly how much money is in your account at any given time. An important tip for the spending log is you're probably going to want to make multiple copies of this sheet because you might have several expenses throughout the month. Of course, some of you are just going to use your bank account and check in every day, but if you do write a lot of checks or if you use cash a lot, a spending log can be really helpful in your budgeting. A budget template, okay, this is the most important part of the book because without a budget, you're going to really struggle to pay off debt and to meet your financial goals. So on the budget, you want to keep track of your income, you want to keep track of any savings you're going to do, and of course all of your expenses, your housing, your utilities, your bare minimum basics. Definitely make sure that those are taken care of first, especially if you're struggling or you're on an inconsistent income. Make sure that you're taking care of things you need to absolutely live before you're paying like the cable bill or anything like that. And of course, there's some blank lines for anything else that you might want to fill in yourself, anything else you might think of. I also love to use budgeting apps too. I like to see it written down, and I also like to use the Every Dollar app. Dave Ramsey's app that he recommends. I really like that one. And I also like to use Mint. I use a lot of different budgeting tools, but it's because I enjoy it and I like it. So I like to try them all out. The debt snowball, really important. If you're trying to pay off debt, you need to know exactly how much you owe. So I like to list all of my debt from smallest to largest, all the way down, the minimum payments, and then how much we're gonna hit those the smallest payment with this month. So with the debt snowball, you do all of your payments from smallest to largest. You attack the littlest one. Once that's paid off, you take what you were paying on the littlest one and you add it to the next one, and you just keep the snowball rolling. Step four on a successful budget binder for your home is, of course, to analyze every month and redo and readjust. Don't give up if the budget just went south. You're just gonna get better and better at budgeting every month that you do it. It really is an act of persistence and making adjustments and finding out what works for you and your family. That's everything that's included in my complete budget toolkit. If you have any questions on how to use the budget printables, please don't hesitate to ask me. I love to help people with their budgets, and I would love to help you use the printables and make a budget binder of your own. If you want to try using the cash envelopes that come with it, you just cut those along the line and fold them. The instructions are pretty clear, and I'll try to make a video on how exactly I use the cash envelope system soon. So I encourage you to keep budgeting, and for more information on budgeting and paying off debt, please visit thefreckledfootdoc.com, and also don't forget to hit subscribe so you can see all future videos about budgeting and paying off debt, and pick up my free budgeting printables, which will be linked below. I will see you soon.